Welcome everyone. Now I am going to explain about natural selection. Okay, in evolution we have three type of evolution, three types. First one is micro, second one is macro, and third one is mega. Okay, micro evolution, macro evolution and mega evolution. These are all three type of evolution. In micro evolution, that evolution operates in species level. Okay, in species level. Okay, so species level, it can make new subspecies. It can make new subspecies by changing of gene frequencies of a population for few generation. So population la gene frequency la changes erpadadhu mulaiyama it can form new subspecies. So it called as micro evolution. Next, macro evolution. Macro evolution, in this type, the type of evolution, it happen above species level. Okay, it can make new family. Okay, or new species, genus, new species, genus and new family, it may be developed in macro evolution. Okay, for example, Australian marsupials. So Australian marsupials are examples of macro evolution. And finally, mega evolution. In mega evolution, it can make a new class or phyla. Okay, so it can make a new phyla or classes. Okay, and it's a mega evolution. The example is the formation of amphibia from fishes. Okay, example. And reptiles from amphibia. Okay, and birds and mammals from reptiles. So these are all the example of mega evolution. Okay, now we are going to see micro evolution. Okay, it operates at species level. Okay, and it make the changes of allelic frequency of population. How to change the allelic frequency of a population in microevolution? It act four important forces to change the allelic frequency of a population to make subspecies. The first one, natural selection. Second one, genetic drift, and third one, gene flow, and fourth one, mutation. So these four are vital forces to change the allelic frequency of a population. It involves in micro evolution. Okay, now we are going to see the first force of microevolution, natural selection. So we know that already discussed about natural selection in theory of Darwin. Okay, now what is natural selection? So we know that nature will favor a particular species to have a certain heritable character which make the organism better survival. Okay, natural selection, and it selects the heritable triad. It select the heritable, okay, heritable triad which make the animal. So idu oru panba select pannudhu, anda panbu anda animal odaya survival better ah survival pandrathukana possibilities enda variations. Okay, it select the heritable variations or ட்ரையட் அப்படின்னு நம்ம சொல்லுவோம். இட்ஸ் ஹெரிட்டபிள் வேரியேஷன், ஹெரிட்டபிள் வேரியேஷன் அண்ட் விச் மேக் த அனிமல் பெட்டர் சர்வைவல். ஸோ எந்த ஆர்கனிசத்தோடைய எந்த ஆர்கனிசத்துக்கு உருவாகிற ஒரு வேரியேஷன் அந்த அனிமலுடைய சர்வைவலுக்கு ரொம்ப ஹெல்ப்ஃபுல்லாக இருக்கும், அந்த வேரியேஷன் என்ன பண்ணுது, நேச்சுரல் சப்போர்ட் பண்ணுது, அதை செலக்ட் பண்ணுது. ஸோ தட் ஆர்கனிசம், தட் அனிமல் ஹாவ் மோர் ஆப்பர்ச்சுனிட்டி டு ரீப்ரொடியூஸ், ஓகே, டு ப்ரொடியூஸ் மோர் ப்ரோஜெனி. ஸோ அப்போ என்னாவது, இட் இன்க்ரீஸ் மோர் ப்ரோஜெனி. Due to increase of more progeny, the changes of alleles, okay, allele frequency change, allele frequency change in that population, okay, so this is called natural selection, okay. And natural selection have three types, in the natural selection la moonu type irukku, okay. One stabilizing, stabilizing selection, and second one is directional, directional selection, and third one disruptive, disruptive selection. So these are all three types of selection in natural selection, okay. Now we are going to see one by one. The first one is stabilizing selection, okay. In first stabilizing selection, it mostly operates, stabilizing, it mostly operates in stable environment, stabilizing selection, it mostly operates in stable environment or constant. In this type of selection, that mean values are selected, so it never change in a population, then never change the mean value, mean value of population. There is no phenotypic changes will happen, no phenotypic changes will happen, and no speciation also, speciation, no speciation also happen into the population. The average population, average phenotypic population was increased, okay, and also decrease peripheral, peripheral characteristics, it decrease peripheral characteristics, and the mean population, the average phenotypic population was increased and also always stable. So it is called stabilizing selection, okay. So when we explain the content in a graph, so this is a normal population graph, it is mean value, center, this is peripheral value, okay. And this type of population, it was due to natural selection, that peak value will narrow, okay, and also increase the height, okay. So the population which is the, okay, that the peak will become narrow and also high. So the peripheral population was decreased and the average value was increased the population. So it balancing, it also called as balancing population. It is in stable form. So in the population average people sunde avaroda population increase aite irukum, and extreme, both extremes, in the extreme population, in the extreme population enna aidum அதோடைய லெவல் குறைஞ்சி வந்துடும். இதுதான் ஸ்டெபிளைசிங் செலெக்ஷன் அப்படின்னு சொல்லுவோம். இதுக்கான எக்ஸாம்பிள் நிறைய இருக்கு, ஓகே. ஹைட் ஆஃப் ஹியூமன், ஹைட் ஆஃப் ஹியூமன்ஸ் வி நோ தட், அண்ட் லோ அண்ட் ஹை and height humans are very few, and also they decrease the number, and average height was selected by nature to increase the population. So romba kullamaga dwarf people appdi nama solluvom, and height more than 7 feet on the population pathina, and less than 5 feet appdin pathina illa 4 feet pathina, it is the population is very less. And average height 5 to 6 it always at high in that human population. So the nature select the stabilizing selection. Okay, and one more example, sickle cell anemia. Sickle cell anemia is also one of the example of natural selection or stabilizing selection or balancing selection. And in sickle cell anemia, homozygote, instead of homozygous, heterozygous, HBS, HBA. The heterozygous animals have some good resistance, because in malaria prone area, the malarial parasite, some life cycle of malarial parasite are in RBC. In sickle cell RBC, the malarial parasite cannot survive. So that person, those have heterozygous condition, they have resistant to malaria. Yeah, so the nature will select that heterozygous population, and that female having the heterozygous condition have more fertility, and also they have resistant for survival of malaria. Okay, so then nature will select, so it continue, the allele was continuing human population, it never get eliminated. So it is also one of the example. Okay, and next, directional selection. Okay, in directional selection, directional selection, that population, it moves towards one peripheral character. In this condition, and one extreme end and also average will population will decrease, and one end of peripheral character was increase. Okay, the both extreme peripheral character, between the both two extreme peripheral character, one extreme character will increase the population, and so that population to move towards one end of a population. Okay, so it called as directional. So idula pathina idodeya and the graph la, okay, this is a graph, it's an average population. In here, that population will move to this type. Okay, so the population towards two, okay, and population move towards a one peripheral, this peripheral value, the character was increase the population, and mean character and also another end of character, another peripheral end of character was decrease. Okay, so it called as directional selection. The example is industrial melanism. We know the industrial melanism. In the Biston Betularia population, moth population, and before industrialization, white and black color moth, white color moth was increased, because natural select, the background color was matches with the white color moths. So predator are feed only dark color moth, but after industrialization, the black color moth are escaped from predator, so it was selected by nature, so it have more opportunity to produce more progenies and more individuals. So the population will increase, dark color moth population was increased, and white color and the medium moths are decreased in that population. So it is called directional. Okay, the population move towards a particular direction to develop a character due to the change of environment. Due to the change of environment and as well as environmental pressure. Okay. And third one. Second. And third one, disruptive. Disruptive selection. In disruptive selection, the population was select and both peripheral characters was increased, only the mean value was decreased. Okay, only the mean value was decreased. Both peripheral are extreme characters. The both extreme. So this is a normal population. Here the population, the extreme characters was increased and the peripheral, sorry, the mean characters was decreased. Here this also increased, this also increased, but the mean value, the mean character was decreased. Okay, so it is called disruptive selection. A population is splitted into two or more subspecies. Rendu illa moonu subspecies ah uruvaagudhu. இதுக்கான எக்ஸாம்பிள் அப்படின்னு பார்த்தீங்கன்னா அடாப்டிவ் ரேடியேஷன். ஸோ அடாப்டிவ் ரேடியேஷன் இஸ் எக்ஸாம்பிள் ஆஃப் டிஸ்ரப்டிவ் செலெக்ஷன். ஒன் ஸ்பீஷியஸ் ஸ்பிளிட்டட் இன்டு டூ ஆர் மோர் சப்ஸ்பீஷியஸ் டியூ டு என்விரான்மெண்டல் ப்ரெஷர். ஓகே, த பெரிஃபரல் கேரக்டர்ஸ் வாஸ் இன்க்ரீஸ் இன் த பாப்புலேஷன். அண்ட் ஒன் மோர் எக்ஸாம்பிள் இஸ் ஆர் ஷெல் பேட்டர்ன் ஆஃப் லிம்பட்ஸ். ஸோ லிம்பட்ஸ் ஆல்சோ ஹாவ் டூ distinct character, one is white and toned color. So white color also escaped from predator and toned color also escaped from predator, but in middle, okay, the average color and middle population, it easily, okay, easily captured by predator, so the population was decreased. Okay, so another one example of size of salmon fish. Size of salmon fish. Okay, it is also example. In small size fish also to escape from the predator and large size fish also escaped, but average size fishes easily captured by predator, so the population is split into small and large, no median and sized fishes, and the population also decrease. So it's called disruptive selection. Okay, so apart from that and some of other selection also, okay, so sexual selection also there, and altruism, kin selection also there in natural selection. Thank you.